up?
I wanted to chit-chat with you before you head out.
All right.
What's going on here at the farm? What do I need to know? And well, because I mean, you're going to be gone, and you know, someone's got to pretend they're you.
The farm right now, it's a fine running machine. It's very, very Camarino's got
it. I know, but we should know. I mean, God forbid if anything were to happen to you, Matt. We need to be aware of what needs to be done. So, you know.
I think those people in the family that wanted to understand. I think Jeremy has wanted that, had less of an interest. He seems to be picking up his interest now.
Okay, well, I guess everyone else is all good. I guess I'm not.
I don't want to, like, get into it, but you can't add to my burden, you know. You have to submerge yourself in it and become involved in it.
Well, yeah, the thing is, you just said, though, don't, you know, put a kink in the system. Don't mess up the plan.
Well, I've been...
Don't get involved, because you'll be messing up everything. I wished over the years that Matt and I were able to work a little more in sync when it comes to the farm. Matt had other people, you know, help him out. So the thought of anything happening to Matt, I would probably really question myself whether I could really take on that suddenly, this gigantic, you know, project called the farm. So I'm just here to monitor.
Well, there's one thing you could do, help out with. There's a really ugly tire over there that I can't stand staring at every time I get on my meal. You could put that away. Anything I can help you with? No, I think I've got just about everything here. I'm gonna bring my normal black and gray and then a little splash of color just in case. I'm getting ready to fly down to LA today for my neck surgery, and you know, it's a pretty serious procedure. I've got to admit that I have a little bit of anxiety about it.
How about your speaker for listening?
Need that, definitely. That's a good idea. Bill is a very, very close friend of mine, and he volunteered. He said, hey, if you need help at the hospital, I'm here for you. And so he's going to come down to L.A. with Zach and I and be there.
Hey, Zach.
Hey. Hey, how are you guys doing?
Good. What's up with you?
How much? You guys ready to head out?
Kind of nervous.
I would be. Yeah, of course I'm worried about my dad. LP surgeries can be kind of scary, but you know, you gotta keep it together and just, I wanna be positive for him.
One last look at my plate before I push off. Everyone in the family has offered to go with me and, you know, be there with me during my surgery. But I didn't want everybody around and being worried. But Zach, he just absolutely insisted on coming with me, and you know, I'm glad that he did. I'm gonna go say goodbye to your mom real quick, okay?
All right, sounds good.
Amy? Hey there, Felix. Hey
I'm Felix.
Ready to...
Hey, what's happening?
Get ready to shove off, take go.
Really?
Yep.
Well, buddy?
Yep, we'll be fine.
This is a delicate surgery that Matt is having done. You know, anything could happen. I think the big thing for me is just being in the role, I guess, of a mom and a wife. I mean, that's what you do. You go. So I'm not used to not doing something like that.
Okay. Thank you. All right. Thank you. Appreciate
that. I hope all goes well.
Yeah. Appreciate it.
This is a very, very serious, scary surgery. I'm just going to pray that, you know, everything goes okay.
Bye.
I'm going down to L.A. because, you know, the doctors down there really have a lot of expertise with little people. It's a fairly invasive procedure, so I'm gonna go into it, trust God to, you know, have his hand on it, and that's all you can do.
Hey, Dad. How are we doing?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm glad you're with me, that's for sure. I kind of got up this morning feeling a little bit of anxiety.
But I feel, now that we're on an airplane, I always settle down.
Good morning, Matt. Today's the big day?
Yep, today's the big day. We got some surgery going on this morning. Time to wake up and get prepared for surgery. It is 4:40 in the morning.
Basically, I am ready to go into my surgery. There might be the very last time I will be putting on my own shirt over my head for a little while. Bill and I stayed here, and Zach's next door in the room. We're going to go wake Zachary up and tell him it's time for D-Day. Zach? Trying to brush my hair and figure out which way do you style your hair when you go in for surgery? Do you part on the side, or do you go straight back, or do they shave it all and it's all just a mute point and doesn't matter?
I don't think my dad's hair is really what he was thinking about. It's more of just a distraction, you know, takes his mind off what he's about to go do. Because this was like minutes before he went in, so like it was getting really real.
All right, let's head out. As we walk over to the hospital, you know, the nerves are definitely starting to kick in a little bit. You know, life as I know it, you know, could potentially change after this surgery.
Registration.
You know, I'm hoping that I lose a lot of the pain that I've been suffering the last couple years, you know, but it's also possible that I could lose my ability to use my arms and my legs. So everything is up in the air right now, and honestly, that's pretty scary. When I had my last operation at about 14 years old, maybe 15, I said, I'm never gonna do that again as long as I live, no matter what. And so here I go. Yeah, here I go. As I'm being wheeled into surgery, I'm thinking, a lot can go wrong, so I hope I survive.